So hi, today we are going to talk about chemical equilibrium, the second part. The first part we talked about the chemical equilibrium and the factors affecting chemical equilibrium, and then we looked at the graphs and then we tried to understand what's going on. Now we are going to talk about Kc, okay? Kc is the chemical equilibrium constant, okay? So what is Kc, chemical equilibrium constant? Let's look at the content. The equilibrium constant, okay, we are going to talk about list of factors that influence the value of equilibrium constant, okay? And actually what we can say, okay, Kc only depends on temperature, okay? Only temperature change will change the Kc value, okay? The pressure and concentration, common ion effect, catalyst will not affect Kc number, okay? And write down the expression for chemical equilibrium constant, having been given the equation. We are going to do that now. And then we are going to do some calculations based on Kc value, okay? And then before we talk about these 3 points, okay, I'm going to talk about the significance of high and low values of the chemical equilibrium constant. And the last point that we are going to discuss today, and if we can manage, explain the use of rate and equilibrium principles in Haber and contact process. Haber process and contact process are two main processes that we see in the fertilizer industry. That's the last topic for grade 12, chemistry paper 2. Last topic is fertilizer industry. And these two processes are in the fertilizer industry and very important, okay? It's a kind of explanation, okay? It's a kind of application. So two simple examples. And before we move into the equilibrium constant, how we write it down, how we write the formula, because each and every chemical equation, it has its own chemical equilibrium constant formula. How do we write down that? Okay, before we talk about that, I'm just going to talk about what do you mean by Kc value, okay? What is this number? Actually, when we look at Kc, for example, Kc is equal to 1, okay? And if it is equal to 1, okay, and then is there a unit next to it? Is there a unit that we use? No. Okay, actually Kc is the ratio between the concentration of products and the reactants. So products divided by reactants. So which means that if this number is equal to 1 and the concentration of reactants and the products are almost like, the concentrations are almost like equal to each other. Okay, so if it is products over reactants, if it is more than 1, so which means that it is going to give me a number. So the products are having more concentration than reactants. If it is less than 1, like for example 1/4, okay, so which means that, okay, the concentration of products are going to be less than reactants. There's going to be less products, okay, produced. So the equilibrium constant Kc indicates the yield of a reaction. Yield means products of a reaction. It talks about us products. If the number is bigger, there is more product. If this Kc number is smaller, there is less products produced, okay? Because it is the ratio between concentration of products divided by reactants, okay? Basically like this, okay? A large Kc value, for example, if it is more than 1, if it is more than 1, okay, indicates a large yield, indicates, tells us that we produce a big amount of products that we can have in the container when the equilibrium is reached, okay? And the equilibrium position is concentration of products compared to reactants, okay? I discussed this. And a small Kc indicates, for example, what is small Kc, like 1 × 10⁻², okay, or like 0.1 or like 0.01, anything less than 1, okay, I can say anything less than 1. For example, less than 1, 0.5, okay, 0.5. And a small Kc indicates a low yield, which means that we have concentration of products are less than concentration of reactants, because we just said that equilibrium constant and position is the concentration of products divided by concentration of reactants. And the equilibrium position is 4 to the left. We know that on the right-hand side, we have products. On the left-hand side, we have reactants. On the right-hand side, products. On the left-hand side, products. So if there is more products, what happens? So the reaction equilibrium position will be to the right, okay? to the direction of products. And if the reactants are on the left-hand side, if the Kc value is small, which means that there is more concentration of reactants, so which means that the equilibrium position will be to the left. That's what we need to understand. And at equilibrium, there is a relatively small amount of products compared to the reactants because the ratio is small. Okay, so which means that if Kc is more than one, there is good amount. Okay, there is more amount of products, more amount of concentration of products than reactants. So the product, okay, that we produce is large. Okay, and if the Kc is less than one, which means that there is more reacted concentration of reactants are more than the concentration of products. So the yield is low. Okay, the products, amount of products is low. And the equilibrium constant is temperature dependent. What do you mean by this? I just discussed that Kc only changes with temperature. For example, I disturb the chemical equilibrium, change the pressure. Is there any change on the Kc value? No. You can directly say, okay, I change the concentration of reactants or products, one of it, okay? And then will there be a change on the Kc value? No. You just need to know that, stick to this. Kc depends on only temperature, okay? Won't change. And when writing Kc expression, first balance the equation. So we must balance the equation. Why? Because the coefficients, the numbers of each number in front of the formula to be able to balance the equation, that's called coefficients, are very important to write a formula, okay? And then ignore all the solids and pure liquids, okay? Since their concentrations are constant, okay? So what happens is that concentration of solids and pure liquids will not change during the reaction. That's why we ignore the solids and liquids in the Kc formula, okay? We don't write in the formula. Only gases and aqua, okay? Only solutions, we know AQ, okay? That symbol, okay, under the formula, that one means solutions, or G under the formula, that one means gas. Only these two should be in the equation for the Kc. And Kc is a number without units. We just said that it's the ratio between the concentrations. So concentration divided by concentration will give you no units, okay? And how do we write the equilibrium constant? Let's look at here. Imagine that you have an equation like this. A plus EB is reversible reaction, CC. So small lowercase letter A and lowercase letter B and C representing the coefficients, numbers that we use to balance the chemical equation, okay? And capital ones are representing the formula. So A and B goes into reaction to produce C, okay? And all of them are, for example, all of them are gas. Imagine that, okay? It's not given here, okay? All of them are gas. We know that only AQ and G, if you see, will be used in the formula, okay, that we are going to write equation, not solids and liquids, because their concentration won't change, okay? So what we need to write? Products divided by reactants, okay? Products divided by reactants, okay? What is the concentration of products? This bracket means the concentration. So concentration of C, and you write the coefficients as the power of the concentration, okay? Divided by concentration of A, we now divide by reactants, and the power is the coefficient, times, okay, concentration of B, and the power is the coefficient in front of the formula B, okay? If you have two products, so C concentration times D concentration, for example, D, and then it will carry on like that. If you have three reactants or three products, you must just multiply, okay? It's not addition, multiplication, okay? Reaction, so the concentration of products, as you can see, C divided by multiplication of concentration of reactants, that's equal to the Kc value, okay? We just discussed that if Kc is more than one, then which means that it goes to the right, because on the right hand side, like C, we will have more C, more products, so there are more products and reactants, higher concentration. You can see from the formula, if Kc is less than one, so which means that there is, the reaction will lying to the left, so which means that there will be more reactants produced, okay? And then there are more reactants than products, but before it reaches the equilibrium, okay? And what about Kc value? We said that it's affected, okay? It depends on the temperature, okay? How does temperature affects the Kc value? If the temperature of a system changes, then the Kc value will change. How? I'll explain the first one, okay? Let's look at the first one in the table. So temperature increase. When I increase the temperature, imagine that your reaction is exothermic, okay? Forward reaction is exothermic. Imagine that. Forward reaction is exothermic, okay? This one tells me that Kc of exothermic reaction. So forward reaction is exothermic. When I increase the temperature, what will happen? The reaction will, according to LCP, reaction will oppose the disturbance. It will decrease the temperature by favoring endothermic reaction. So the reverse reaction will be favored, okay? If the reaction is exothermic and if you increase the temperature, reverse reaction will be favored. What will happen if the reverse reaction will be favored? So amount of C will decrease and amount of A and B increases. What will happen to the Kc value? As you can see, decrease, okay? What about the next one? I'll explain the next one and then we can move to the next one. Next slide, okay? So Kc of exothermic, forward reaction is exothermic. You decrease the temperature. When I decrease the temperature according to LCP, okay? Le Chatelier's principle, reaction will do it will do the opposite of what we are doing. And if we decrease the temperature in the second condition, it will increase the temperature by favoring the reaction. Which one is that? Exothermic reaction. So it will favor the forward reaction. Forward reaction favored will be faster than the reverse one. So for a while, so which means that there will be more C, amount of C will be more, and amount of A and B will be less. So Kc value will increase. Can you see that it will increase? Okay, that's how it changes. And the endothermic will be opposite. You can do it yourself. And how do we calculate equilibrium constant? We just learned in general, how can I write Kc? What about in one number example? How can I do that? Imagine that you have a question like this, as you can see in the box here, okay? And then how am I going to find the equilibrium constant for this reaction? 3 moles of NO2, as you can see, NO2 is changing into N2O4, different gas. You remember this one is brown and this one is colorless gas. We did it in the previous slides, okay, last class. And then are placed in a 1.5 decimeter cube container, okay? So you have 1.5 decimeter container, you pump in 3 moles of nitrogen dioxide gas, NO2. And the following equilibrium is established. And then what happens is that NO2 will be used. There is no N2O4 in the container first. Some NO2 will be used. And then reverse reaction will start. And then what happens is that after a while, the speed of, okay, rate of forward reaction will decrease. And the rate of reverse reaction will increase. And they will reach the same speed, okay? And then what will happen? The equilibrium will be reached. So the rate of forward will be equal to rate of reverse reaction, okay? And at equilibrium, it was found that 0.3 moles of NO2 was present in the container. Calculate the value of equilibrium constant for this reaction, okay? So what happens is that you put 3 moles and then you produce some NO2 and then after a while, what happens is that some of this NO2 is used and you produce some N2O4. And then what happens is that the equilibrium is reached. And from that point, amount of NO2 and the amount of N2O4 will not change, okay? That's what we need to know. So this is the 0.3 moles is the one when it started not changing, okay? It will produce NO2 will produce 0.3 moles of, 0.3 moles of NO2 will be left and the others will turn into N2O4, okay? And then we are going to calculate equilibrium constant. For this one, what do I use is always Rice table. I call this table Rice table. Do we have to use Rice table? No, it's one way of, okay, putting calculations together. What you can do, you can just do this calculations that I'm going to discuss now yourself in order, it's up to you, okay? But what am I using is easiest way. I feel that this is the easiest way to use the Rice table. Why do we call this Rice table? Look at the titles in the table. the ratio, initial mole, change mole, equilibrium mole, equilibrium constant. Can you see the first letters for each, okay, title? R, I, C, E, E. That's why I call it rice table, okay? How do you want to call it? Okay, I call it rice table with two E. And then you just write down in this table NO2, okay, and N2O4, okay? And then all calculations, everything is going to be in this table. And then if I need any calculation, I'll show it outside. And first of all, what do I need to write? This ratio is the mole ratio. What is the mole ratio in this equation? As you can see from the equation, 2 moles of NO2 producing 1 mole of N2O4, okay? The second one is initial moles. Before the reaction starts, how much from each you have, okay? We just said that we put 3 moles of NO2 and there was no N2O4. So which means that initially we have 3 moles of NO2 and 0 moles of N2O4. That's done. The next title, change. I cannot talk about change now, so I have to move to the next one. Okay, let's skip this, and then I'll come back to change. And then equilibrium. What is given in the question? What is given in the question is, okay, the at equilibrium, 0.3 moles of NO2 was present. Okay, when the equilibrium is reached, some of these 3 moles is used. How much left? When it reached equilibrium, how much left? 0.3 moles of NO2 left in the container, not used up. And others, what happened to others? They turn into N2O4, okay? They changed into N2O4. So this is also given in the question. So what am I going to do first? I'm going to find out how much NO2 in number of moles is used. Initially, how much we had in the container before the reaction starts? 0, okay? And then finally, and then it reaches equilibrium and there will be no change in the number of moles and the concentration of reactants and products, 0.3 moles. So 3 minus 0.3, okay, is going to give me 2.7. So what happens is that actually I use 2.7 moles of NO2, okay, before the reaction reaches equilibrium. So 3 minus 2.70, so 2.7 is equal to 0.3 moles of, okay, NO2 left. So minus means used up, okay? So if I use 2.7 moles of NO2, how much N2O4 will be produced, okay? So I'm going to use mole ratio. Look at here, what was the mole ratio? 2 moles, 1 mole. So if this one is 2.7 moles used, how many moles will be produced? So 2 to 1, 2.7 divided by 2, it's going to be 1.35. If you use your calculator, you will see. So why this one is plus? Because when I use this minus, okay? When I use this minus, this one is produced. How much? We just calculated by using mole ratio, 1.35. So plus, so 0, initial mole, it was 0. And then what happened? What is the change? You added 1.35 or produce 1.35 moles of N2O4, and then how much will be at equilibrium? 1.35 moles. Now what do I know? I know the number of moles of each substance. When it reaches equilibrium, there is no change, okay? Number of moles of each substance at equilibrium, okay? NO2 is 0.3, N2O4 is 1.35. Next step, what we need to do is that we need to find the concentration of each, okay, at equilibrium, okay, and what is the volume of the container? 1.5 decimeter cube, okay. What is the volume of container? 1.5 decimeter cube. And then if you have a gas in the container, okay, which means that gas, the gas takes up the space of the container, so the volume of container is equal to volume of gas, each gas, okay, so which means the volume of NO2 is 1.5 decimeter cube, volume of N2O4 is 1.5 decimeter cube, okay? And then, if I use the concentration formula on the left-hand side, as you can see, C is equal to N over V, okay? What is N? 0.3 divided by 1.5, it's going to be 0.2 mole per decimeter cube. That's the concentration of NO2 at equilibrium. And the second one is C is equal to N is 1.35 at equilibrium divided by 1.5, and then you find 0.9. and this is the concentration of N2O4 at equilibrium. Okay, what is the last point? Now I know the concentration of NO2 and N2O4 at equilibrium. What do I need to write down? I need to write down the Kc equation. Okay, what is the first rule for Kc equation? Only aqua, okay, aqua and the gas, only solutions, aq or gas phase. Okay, if there is solid, liquid, don't put it in the Kc formula. Okay, as you see, this one is gas, so all of them should be in the Kc. And the second step, the concentration of product. What is product? N2O4, and these brackets means concentration. And what is the coefficient in front of N2O4? What is the ratio? 1. Okay, coefficient 1. There is 1 here always. Okay, so the power is 1. You can't see there is 1 here because the power is 1. And divided by, is there any other products? No. So let's move to the reactants. Divided by, and the concentration of NO2, and what is the coefficient in front of it? And to the power of 2. Okay. And then what we need to do, this is the concentration of N2O4 at equilibrium. This is the concentration of NO2 at equilibrium. We already found it, okay? So it's going to be 0.9 power 1, 0.2 power 2, and it's going to give us 22.5. Kc is more than 1, and it's a big number. So which means that it gives us a good yield of, okay, large yield of N2O4, okay? So the concentration of products are higher than concentration of reactants. Okay, and then can I show you one more example before we move to the applications? Can I show you one more example? Okay, I have one more example here. Okay, can I just do this example and then I can move to the next point? So question two, I'm just going to skip that, I'll come back to that. Consider the following hypothetical reaction. Okay, A in gas form plus 2B gas and the reversible reaction, and C gas. Okay, delta H is more than zero. What do you mean by delta H is more than zero? Delta H more than zero means that the energy is absorbed from the environment. The forward reaction, we know that this delta H is for forward reaction. Forward reaction is endothermic and the reverse reaction is exothermic. I can directly talk about this, but I don't think we need this for now. Okay, next one. Initially 5 mole of A and 10 mole of B are pumped into 4 decimeter cube reaction flask. Flask is the container, closed container, at 650 Kelvin degrees. I don't think we need to use these 650 Kelvin degrees. Okay, and at equilibrium, the concentration of C. Okay, concentration of C product was found to be 1.2 mole per decimeter cube. Okay, and first of all, they want you to calculate concentration of A at equilibrium. Secondly, they want you to calculate the concentration of B at equilibrium. Third, they want you to find the equilibrium constant for this reaction. What am I going to do? I'm going to do all of this in the next slide. Okay, I put it in the Rice table. This is also a Rice table, short one. Okay, I didn't like this, the one that is used in the answers. Okay, I want to use the long one. Okay, let's look at here. What is given in the question? Okay, what is given in the question? Can I just add one more thing here? Okay, just highlight this also. Okay. So these red ones are given in the question. Okay, what is given in the question? Initially 5 mole A, 10 mole B. Is that right? Initial amount, okay, we have 10 minutes left. Initial amount of mole, 5 mole A, 10 mole B. Okay, correct. And at equilibrium, the concentration of C was found to be 1.2 mole per decimeter cube. Okay, equilibrium concentration. What is the concentration of C? 1.2 mole per decimeter cube. So I'm going to use these, and then I'm going to use this. As you can see, the reaction is here, and to be able to find the Kc, and step by step everything. Actually, they want you to do 2.1, 2.2, 2.3. Step by step, find Kc. I'm going to show you how to do that, okay? So this is Rice table. The first one is the ratio. That's called mole ratio. What is the mole ratio between A, B, and C? Okay. One mole, as you see, coefficient is one. Okay. Two moles in the reaction is, okay, and then one mole of C produce. One mole A and two mole B goes into reaction to be able to produce one mole of C. Okay. And then what is the initial amount? Initially in the reaction container, we pump in 5 moles of A and 10 moles of B, and there is no C. If there is no C, what we can write down here? 0 moles of C. And what is the change in mole? What is the change in mole? How can I find that? Not now. What is the equilibrium mole? How can I find? Not now. It's not possible now. And the equilibrium concentration might be, okay? So there is no other number. So why did they give this 1.2 mole per decimeter cube? That's what I'm looking for, okay? So because by using this, can I find the number of moles of C at equilibrium? Yes. What is the formula? C is equal to N over V. Look at the right-hand side. C is equal to N over V. And I know C, 1.2 mole per decimeter cube. And why V is 4 decimeter cube? Because the container, okay, container volume is 4 decimeter cube. And each and every gas occupies the same volume if they are in the same container. So the volume of these, C is going to be also 4, okay? And then if you do substitution 4 and 1.2, and if you do cross multiplication, you are going to see that N times 1 is equal to 1.2 times 4, and is the number of moles is equal to 4.8 moles of C at equilibrium. So we found 4.8 moles of C at equilibrium, okay? What is the initial amount of C? 0. What is the final? Okay, at equilibrium, 4.8. So how much produced? 0 to 4.8 plus 4.8 moles. So 4.8 moles of C produced during the reaction before it reaches equilibrium, okay? So I found this. Now I'm going to go back by using mole ratio. What is the mole ratio between B and C? 2 mole B and 1 mole C, okay? If I produce 4.8 moles of C, 4.8 moles of C, sorry, here, okay? How much B do I need? Can I find that? How many moles of B do I need? Can I find that? Yes, how many moles do I need to use? Yes, I can find it. How? 1, 2 mole ratio, 4.8 times 2. So what is 4.8 times 2? 9.6 moles of B will be used. That's why this one is minus, okay? Minus used, which means change in. Minus means used, okay? 9.6 moles. And the next step, okay? 4.8 moles of C used. What is the mole ratio between C and A? 1 and 1. C and A, 1 used, 1 will be produced. So if I produce 4.8 moles of C, how many moles of A do I need to use? 4.8. Use means negative because change is negative, okay? Used up, okay? 4.8 moles. Now I know all of these change in moles. Can I find the equilibrium mole for B and C? Yes. So I had 10 moles. I used 9.6 moles. How much left? 10 minus 9.6, 0.4 moles will be left at equilibrium. And this is the amount that will not change because it's in at equilibrium, okay? Whatever the reactions there are, speed of forward reaction is equal to reverse. That's why there will be no change in the amount of reactants and products. And when we look at initial amount of A, 5 moles and minus 4.8 moles, and that's going to give me 0.2 moles of A left in the container after the reaction reaches equilibrium. Okay, now I know the number of moles of A and B at equilibrium. Can I find the concentration? Yes, use the same formula. C is equal to N over V. What is the volume? For all gases, volume is 4, okay? So N is 0.2 divided by 4, 0.05 mole per decimeter cube. Yes, correct. And C is equal to N over V. And then what is the number of moles? 0.4 divided by 4. That's going to give us 0.1 mole per decimeter cube. Yes, that is our concentration for equilibrium. Now, did we find the concentration of A at equilibrium? Yes. What is that equal to? 0.05. And what is the concentration of B at equilibrium? 0.1 mole per decimeter cube. We are done. So the last question is the equilibrium constant for this reaction. So how can I write equilibrium constant for this reaction? If you look at here, the the equilibrium constant Kc is going to be the concentration of C product. And what is the number in front of C? 1, okay? So that's going to be power 1 divided by, is there another product? No, divided by and the concentration of A, and is there a number in front of it? Coefficient, no, 1. So power is 1 and concentration of B. What is the number coefficient in front of B? 2 and the power 2. That's our Kc equation, okay, formula for this reaction. And then what do I know? I know the concentration of C is equal to 1.2 mole per decimeter cube at equilibrium. I know the concentration of A is 0.05 mole per decimeter cube at equilibrium. I know the concentration of B is 0.1 mole per decimeter cube at equilibrium. And then if I do the substitution and you get 2,400, it is a very big number, okay, huge number, okay? So which means that you have a high, large yield of this, okay? So amount of concentration of C is much, much more bigger than the concentration of A and B, okay? It's a large yield, okay, large yield reaction, okay? So that's how we can find Kc, okay? This is not one type of question that might come, but for most of the question types, we use this formula. Sometimes they give you Kc. They're asking for one of these like initial mole or change in mole or number of moles at equilibrium. That's what kind of questions that we are expecting. Okay. 240, yes, might be. It might be 240. Let's check. Okay, somebody said just now, can I just go out? Can you see the screen? Okay. Somebody said Kc value is wrong. Might be wrong because I copied from a worksheet. Okay. There were mistakes on that worksheet. I for correcting. Let's calculate. Okay. You cannot see the calculator, but you can see that. Okay. So I'm just going to do it. So 1.2 divided by 0.05 and divided by 0.01. Okay. What did I do? I don't know. Okay, so one more time. Sorry. So it is 1.2, it's correct now, divided by 0.05 divided by 0.01. Okay. 2400. I think it's 2400. I also found that. Can I just show you? Okay, calculator. You can see calculator now. So 1.2 divided by 0.05. And divide by 0.01 because 0.1.
Sir, it is 0.1, sir.
Is it 0.1? Yes, it is 0.1, but it's the square of. Okay, if you look at here, can I just show you? You can see. Okay, it is the square of. It's supposed to be the square of 0.1. Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir. It's right, sir. It's right.
Okay? I think it should be. Can we go back to the calculator? It should be 2000.
I got the same answer, sir.
Yeah. So can we have 1 minute? Okay. Can I just stop here?